King Richard starring Will Smith is officially out in both theaters and on HBO Max, and the movie has received widespread acclaim. The 2.5-hour picture is certified fresh by Rotten Tomatoes, earning a 91% critic score and an even better 99% audience mark. King Richard is written by Zach Bailyn and directed by Reynaldo Marcus Green and was released on November 19th. Before I get into this review, I want to note that there are minor spoilers, but there really isn't too much to spoil because pretty much everyone already knows about the Williams sisters story itself. Now, many people who didn't even watch King Richard, might I add, complain that the film focused more on the patriarch of the Williams household than the actual sisters themselves. For one, we need to remember that Venus and Serena supported this movie as executive producers. Their sister Esha was also heavily involved with the storytelling of this movie, even acting as Venus and Serena's representatives on set. Actually watching this movie, I didn't think Richard was the sole focus of the movie at all, to be honest. Really, I think it's more about Venus, which makes sense, as even Serena said it's like a love letter to her. Before I get into that aspect, I want to highlight the interesting approach this film took with its start. The opening few scenes see Richard scrambling from club to club, as he pitches his plan for the girls to different coaches. I honestly thought he was doing all this with the girls not even being born yet, but Venus, played by Sanaa Sidney, and Serena, played by Demi Singleton, are indeed there in the flesh, being around 10 and 11 at the beginning of the movie. Instead of it starting with Richard seeing Virginia Ruzici claim the $40,000 purse, it's only mentioned in conversation. I think taking a different approach and starting earlier could have been interesting, as I feel like it could have made for a more complete storyline. For example, in his book, Black and White, The Way I See It, Richard talked about how he taught himself and Orskin the game of tennis through unconventional methods. On my first watch, I preferred that over the scenes of Venus playing her junior events because they seemed a bit repetitive at the time. However, watching the movie again, I had no problem at all with the junior scenes because they highlighted Venus's dominance for one. Then it also showed how toxic the tennis community was and still is, really. I think tennis-wise, everything was technically sound. The main actors and even the extras had good strokes, which was very pleasing as a tennis fan and player myself. I also appreciated how the girls formed gradually improved as they developed. Venus and Serena have talked about how much they are compared to one another growing up. I don't think that competitive aspect between them was highlighted at all in this film. There was a scene where Venus and Serena were sitting down after a tournament, and V offered to trade her gold trophy for her little sister's silver. Venus actually beat Serena before that, so it could have been interesting to see the film cover that matchup and the dynamic of the girls playing one another. I do get their ultimate decision because, once again, the focus is on Venus, and the other sisters are really her supporting characters, even Serena. Speaking of which, the tight-knit family dynamic was highlighted well, from the sisters' humble beginnings in Compton, all the way to Oakland, where V made her pro debut. In his book, Richard says he fought with gang members for control over the courts. However, in the movie, he had conflict with them after they harassed his eldest daughter, Yatunde. Related to this, in the movie, he brings a gun with him while approaching the men who beat him up and catcalled Tundi. However, just as he's about to confront them, the main antagonizer is killed in a drive-by. Meanwhile, in the book, Richard searches for the gang members but is unable to find any. However, on the way home, he found one of the gang members who beat him lying dead in the street. I'm still surprised that there weren't as many Compton moments within this movie. The dangers of the era were portrayed fairly clearly, but I would have liked to see more scenes of Richard putting the girls through unconventional training methods. They did show how they threw old tennis rackets to work on their serves, and how they delivered phone books to build upper body strength. However, I would have preferred to see more profound moments, like how Richard paid Trojan to hurl invectives at the girls while they were training. I believe more of those unconventional approaches were highlighted at the country club type scene. For example, while Venus was working with Paul Cohen, he pushed for an open stance. Then, when the girls were with Rick Macy, there was the adamance of no juniors and a big hesitancy for Venus especially to turn pro. In the movie, Richard expressed many of his fears through highlighting Jennifer Capriati's career trajectory. Capriati was mentioned a lot here, first as this successful prodigy made it compare Venus to. Then, after Capriati went off the ledge a bit, Richard used that to push against Venus going pro. However, after significant pushback, he ultimately let Venus play the tournament. Speaking of the tournament, I didn't expect the route the writers took with this one at all. The biggest disparity was the setting itself, because the Oakland tournament where Venus made her debut was held indoors at the time. In the movie, the event was outdoors. I was also surprised by how nonchalant they portrayed Venus's debut match against Sean Stafford. It actually took me a minute to register that that was her first match because of how little buildup or fanfare there was. In reality, a lot of reporters and eyes were there covering Venus's first match. In the movie, they had her playing on an outside court with a handful of spectators. Also, technically the movie has some inaccuracies as they had Stafford leading Venus in the opening set for Love. However, Venus won the match 6-3, 6-4, and there wasn't really a comeback from behind win. Then, they really hyped up her match against the world number 2 Arantxa Sánchez Vicario. This was done to highlight that sports movie aspect as they typically have that one big game or match to captivate the audience. Initially, I strongly disagree with that approach because these matches against Arantxa wasn't very big in the grand scheme of things. For the Stafford match, there was about 900 spectators, and for the Vicario one, 6,000 people were in attendance, so perhaps that's why there was such a disparity on the big screen. However, there's a lot more footage and reports about the debut match than the Vicario match. It honestly deserved much less screen time, but the writers likely felt that there needed to be a big match with conflict for cinematic purposes. I still think highlighting Arantxa's 8-10 minute bathroom break was a little unnecessary and disengaging. But once again, for the route they took, I understand. Now transitioning to talk about the acting. In King Richard, Venus was extremely disappointed with the loss to Sánchez, which is understandable, as it's her first ever loss in a sanctioned match. In reality though, Venus was positive about her performance, at least to the press, saying, "I think I have the game to beat anyone. I'm not going to say I can't beat Sánchez Vicario. I can't just accept she's better. That would be putting her on a different level than I am." I think the film could have done a better job at highlighting how well Venus handled this occasion, it being her very first pro tournament and first few matches period in over 3 years. The fact that she nearly beat the world number 2 at 14 years old is incredible, and I think ending things with a striking quote from her highlighting her resilience could have been better. The ending they went with was probably more effective at striking that feel-good aspect and providing that same happy ending Venus and Serena had as successful tennis players. I did think the transition to the montage at the end was really great, by the way. I do wish there were more moments from Sanaa, who played Venus, as once again, she was probably the biggest character in the whole movie. I think Will Smith did a solid job playing Richard, but something about his performance threw me off for some reason in my first watch. Oftentimes, it felt like a caricature of Richard, which could have been because he looks absolutely nothing like him. I think that threw me off a lot too. Venus and Serena said that he did a great job portraying their father, so maybe that all that matters, but to me, it was just difficult to see Will as Richard. Now, the standout performance was definitely from Anjanou Ellis, who played Oracine Price. Not only did she look like Oracine, but she truly embodied her. Before watching the movie, I hoped the writers would accurately highlight Oracine's impact on the girl's development, and I think they did an amazing job. Many people aren't aware that she was a coach too. In Compton, she primarily worked with Serena while Venus was training with Cohen. She also wasn't afraid to challenge Richard's tennis teachings. She also pushed back on his many unorthodox parenting methods. One thing that stuck out to me from Richard's book was how he kicked the girls out of the car for talking about tennis too much. In the movie, he did this after Isha, I believe, was bragging after Venus won a tournament. Oracine was furious with Richard for this and insisted he drive back to pick her girls up. That maternal motherly character was very prominent throughout the film, especially when Oracine addressed that neighbor who called CPS on them. It was evident that her children were her main priority, even over Richard. She loved and cared for her then husband, but the movie did a good job of showing how their marriage was more on the downturn. Even though Isha says she wanted Richard to be portrayed as a hero, he definitely wasn't a perfect man. You particularly saw his imperfections when Oracine mentioned his son from a previous marriage popping up. I'm glad Richard's other family was alluded to in the movie because it is a notable part of the story. If you don't know, Richard had a family before Oracine and Venus and Serena. He was previously married to Betty Johnson, with whom he had 5 other children. One of his daughters, Sabrina, called Richard a sperm donor who left her mom to grow up in the conditions of poverty. "I was 8 when my dad left and said he was getting a bike from me, and that's the last I saw of him," Sabrina said. "My mom later told me that he's never coming back. We went from having everything to nothing." I think they could have delved deeper into Williams' darker moments, but it definitely would have changed the movie's dynamic by taking away the hero dynamic and feel-good aspect. Still, I think the audience fully grasped that Richard, while responsible for one of the greatest stories in history, had his faults. But through all of this, his daughters transformed both the sport and the entire world. Overall, I really enjoyed this movie, especially on the second watch. I think it's going to become one of those classic go-to movies that really anybody can enjoy. I definitely recommend you all go out and watch it. Before I finish, I want to commend the other actors for their excellent work. Sanaa especially did a great job as young Venus, as did Demi for Serena. Then, aside from Smith, the casting for this movie was great. Anjanou I mentioned looks like Orsine, but Demi's like a young Serena phenotype. Anyways, if you did watch King Richard, let me know what you think about it in the comments below. Did you like it like I did, or do you think it may have missed the mark? Also, make sure you subscribe and click the notification bell so you're notified whenever I post new content. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time here on Grand Slam Tennis News Today.